Okay, back at the cottage. We're not doing too much exciting work today. Really, it's a cleaning up and organizing day. We're going to try to clean up underneath the building and in the building because the work is going to start to move inside again. So it can't be a terrible, terrible mess where we're tripping over everything. And we've got quite a bit of debris left over from doing the siding. So. Yeah, it's probably not going to be a ton of filming because I've already done 3 full videos on clearing this building out, but I will, you know, I'll do a few clips and show you some befores and afters. Okay, back to work here at the cottage, and I know I haven't posted a video in a while because I've been working on this. Originally I wanted to get more scaffolding and found that I could not find any more, so that meant cobbling together this old rusty scaffolding with the best of my abilities to make it safe. The reason I did this is when I did this side of the building, half of it was on scaffolding, half of it was on ladders. It really dragged out the process, and I thought made it more dangerous than it needed to be. So this, right now, I can reach that top corner of the building from that upper scaffolding. So this should be much safer. Also this morning, you know, I tore down the first 4 courses of siding, exposing the foundation, which thankfully it looks good, and exposing the tongue and groove inside the building. Another reason I haven't been working out here is, so this building has electrical in it, but it definitely needs more electrical. So I'm really, was really didn't know what to do, because obviously electrical is much easier to do from the outside than the inside because of the tongue and groove. And I'll give you guys a look at what I'm talking about. Okay, up here on the first level of scaffolding, other than the huge amount of rat's nests that I have to remove, I'll give you guys a look at what I'm talking about. So, right here, you know, this is 3/4 inch tongue and groove, very similar to hardwood floors. And, you know, I just think trying to put wiring in this wall, which this wall will need a couple of outlets added, you know, I don't know what I can do to get access. Now, I can come at it from the outside, but that means then leaving all of this exposed with wiring exposed for a long period of time till I can finish it out and possibly even have it inspected. So I think the best thing I can do actually is from the outside, I think if I can knock some of this tongue and groove off without damaging it, then I can leave it open on the inside, maybe the first foot even, up to where the new outlets would be. That way I can wire it when I need to and have it inspected if it's needed. So that's my current plan. So first things first, rat nest removal. This will be fun. Let me go get a mask and gloves. Thank you. to work here at the cottage. Sorry, the camera died yesterday when I was removing the siding off this half of the building. But, you know, you guys have seen me remove siding before if you've watched any of my videos. And another video, if you want to go back and watch, is this corner right here is where the beehive that I removed is. It would have been much nicer to not cut that big giant hole in the tongue and groove and do it from the outside like I'm doing now. But, you know, I think I actually did it the right way. I did it the safest way I could. I didn't want to be on top of the scaffolding in a bee suit trying to do that. So that's what we did. Anyway, there's a lot of old wax and comb and crystallized honey on these studs, I guess. So I'm going to scrape that off, and then we're going to try to get insulation and house siding up on this half before the rain comes. It looks like it might want to do that a little bit. So, all right, back to work. Half the building cleaned out and insulated. I probably hold off on house wrap. I'm running out of day late here, and I just don't want to rush it. You know, I'll be sloppy. But I think if I tarp it really good, it should make it all right. I mean, it's going to rain a lot this upcoming week, but I don't think there's that much I could do about it. Hopefully, I'll be able to throw a video together. Sorry, hasn't been going so well with the videos. A lot of it's just planning and set up. So like setting up all this scaffolding, like this was like 2 weekends of work to take down the scaffolding, fix this rusty garbage scaffolding that I have, welding, you know, grinding, fitting, all that stuff. And I'm trying to do this a lot safer than I did the other side. And I think this side went a lot safer. I felt a lot more comfortable on this scaffolding than I felt on top of all those ladders. So I think it should go a lot faster too, but hopefully that'll help the videos come a little faster in the future. All right, thanks everybody for watching.